also identified one more missing item.
There had been a large travel bag lying in front of the TV that had been there for weeks and weeks, that they literally would have to step over and get into the bathroom, and that was missing.
A travel golf bag, possibly like this one, is commonly used by golfers to protect their clubs.
Since all padded, very large.
Very large. It was padded, it was silver, and she thought it was maybe 2 to 2.5 feet wide.
Detectives wondered if Zacco had a more sinister use for the bag.
Would his body even fit inside that travel bag?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
But how did Zacco get that bag out of his apartment? There is no video of Zacco leaving on any of the 28 surveillance cameras in the building.
There's no camera on the elevator, so he could take her body in the travel golf bag out of his apartment, into the elevator, down to the first floor, and out that door to the garage without being captured on any cameras.
But there are cameras inside the garage, and yet nothing of Zacco with that bag.
The garage is the only area where the cameras would be motion activated. Some of the investigators think he just got lucky with it.
It took months of painstaking work for Milwaukee PD investigators to piece together Chris Zacco's movements on the days after his death in Kelly's wire. Lieutenant Eric Gulbranson worked the case as both a homicide and cold case detective.